Hello everyone, I am Lata Jha and a very warm welcome to the latest episode of our show, Business of Entertainment, your weekly dose of the financial performance of what's buzzing in the world of entertainment, at the movies, on TV and on streaming platforms around you. Now the big news this week is the resumption of television shoots across the country, the government mandate to begin TV shoots across India earlier this month came as a breather for TV broadcasters and producers who've started shooting with guidelines even as constraints remain about a week ago. Now, one important aspect of this is the insurance cover required by producers. The idea that a team member can fall sick while shooting or on the set is a fear that many producers have across film, TV and web projects, with many of them wondering if they have to incur the expenses of halting production and quarantining the entire unit, especially if it is an outdoor schedule. The other fear is to get actors to come to work. While majority of them are ready, some are still not willing, with it being a question of life versus livelihood. Besides, writers have had to tweak storylines to account for social distancing measures, besides using mannequins in scenes where physical touch is required between actors. Producers are also abiding by government mandates to have thermal checks, PPE kits, sanitizers, packaged food and disposable cutlery on sets. Call times are early and shoots take place between 6 a.m. and 8 p.m. While the main studio floor is sanitized twice a day, before and after the shoot, makeup rooms and washrooms are sanitized every 1 hour. As of now, the main shoot is confined to a studio with nobody venturing outdoors to places such as roads or other buildings. The number of people on the main set is restricted to 35, with many activities such as editing and programming being done from home or the company's other offices. Makeup of actors is also carried out in rooms beyond the main studio so that other people such as makeup personnel do not have to enter the main set. As far as web offerings go, Netflix is out with Bulbul, an original film produced by Anushka Sharma this week, starring Tripti Dimri, Avinash Tiwari and Rahul Bose. This refreshingly feminist tale is both feisty and disturbing, but makes up for an uneven initial pace with strong performances that eventually bring it all together. One is happy to note that Netflix finally has a local Indian product it can be proud of. Ironic for the same week as the very empowering Bulbul, Amazon has Raspari, a web show starring Swara Bhaskar, which may be a boon for sexually repressed India, which is absurd tedium for the rest. Do write in to us if you can figure out what Bhaskar is doing on this show. That's all we have as far as entertainment goes this week. We will be back next week with more news and context on all that's fun and entertaining in hopefully better times. Till then, stay safe and thanks for tuning in.